Hey guys, it's Game On Head here. I'm here to follow up on the video I did about rotating images in MS Paint. Due to a recording oversight, it didn't record the pop-up window that I guess appeared, and so I'm going to be making it again just to demonstrate how to rotate stuff in MS Paint. Let's begin by drawing something simple like a stick man. Yeah, here we have one. Now we're gonna put them in a roughly square container using the select tool. And you're gonna want to press the resize button, and if you hover over it, you'll actually see that's resize and skew. So what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to use the skew tool and enter the angle you want to rotate it by, positive in the horizontal and then negative in the vertical. So for example, if I'm gonna rotate this guy 30 degrees, I would put 30 here, negative 30 here, and that actually adds to a clockwise rotation. If you want to rotate counterclockwise, you're going to want to put negative value in the horizontal and positive value in the vertical. So here we go. That's a stick man that has been rotated. It works with text as well. So if I just type something like that, and then select the text, and then resize, let's go for a counterclockwise spin. Now, one thing you're going to want to be aware of is, say I want to rotate this by 22.5, which is half of a 45 degree angle. Well, you're not going to be allowed to do that. It has to be a full number. It says, invalid numbers include spaces, decimals, zero, a positive symbol by itself, and a negative symbol by itself. So what I would do is instead say 23 as opposed to 22.5. It might not be perfect, but it's the best that we have with MS Paint. So here you go. The text has been rotated counterclockwise by 23 degrees. It's not very... MS Paint is not very well built for this kind of stuff. So I would not recommend using this if you're going to be doing anything like this. Often, I mean, you can really tell on the stickman here that all these jagged edges where there were... Well, I mean, I could see that this line would be jagged, but I would not say that you should preserve those jagged lines. So if you're going to be doing something where the smoothness of the lines is important, I would recommend you do a second pass over it. And better yet, just don't use MS Paint for this kind of stuff. But if you want to, or you for some reason have to, you absolutely can. And that's how you rotate images and text in MS Paint. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.